Hello and welcome to the Study Travel TV studio in London. I'm Matthew Knott.
And I'm Nicola Hancox, bringing you the latest news stories.
So the top headlines this week: Centre of English Studies acquires Global Village Toronto.
Education South Africa schools gain government registration.
And Emerald Cultural Institute to open new Dublin City Centre school.
And lots of other positive news stories besides, not least a 20-year anniversary for the Alfie conferences.
Absolutely, yes. But first up, ELT provider Centre of English Studies, or CES, has entered the Canadian market with the acquisition of the Global Village Toronto School, becoming the company's eighth centre worldwide.
Justin Quinn, Managing Director of CES, told Study Travel magazine that GV Toronto, established in 1979, was an excellent fit as a fellow ELC member and that the school has 27 year-round classrooms as well as additional summer capacity.
Explaining the expansion, he commented that over recent years, agents around the world have asked CES to open a school in Canada. He added that a big part of the move was that Robin Adams, head of marketing for GV, will be joining the company as president of CES in North America.
Other Global Village schools are not part of the deal, and CES stressed that all existing bookings at Toronto will continue as normal.
Very good. And positive news from Africa next, where Language School Association Education South Africa's member schools have received formal recognition and accreditation as private colleges by the Department of Higher Education and Training.
The announcement means that international students attending the association's schools will be eligible for full study permits, bringing to an end a long-running dispute with the government over the status of the ELT sector that the association claimed had damaged growth.
Johannes Kraus, chairperson of Education South Africa, said the process should now be clear, unambiguous, streamlined and stress-free for students and agents. He said the association was looking forward to growing the industry again.
And more from the Irish sector, where ELT provider Emerald Cultural Institute, or ECI, has announced it will move its Milltown Park Dublin operations to a new city centre location in Merrion Square from October.
Mauro Biondi, managing director of Emerald, said a lot of energy had gone into finding the new home and that they could now provide partners and students with two fantastic locations at Merrion Square and the headquarters in Palmerston Park, with combination courses available for longer-term students.
And now for a roundup of some of the other news stories this week. And ATC Language Schools has announced the opening of a new year-round dedicated junior campus in Dublin, which will feature 13 classrooms in a city centre location. Programmes offered include the World of Work and an intensive business apprenticeship course for older teenage students.
It's all happening in Ireland,
isn't it?
Yeah. UK-based Wimbledon School of English has opened its first overseas school in Laos in partnership with Panyathip International School, offering programmes to the school's students and the local population.
Growth has slowed for English UK in the second quarter of 2018, according to the latest quarterly intelligence cohort data, which shows Saudi Arabia as the top market for the period, and agents accounting for 77% of student weeks.
Very good. An increasing number of international students intend to seek work and permanent residency in Canada after they graduate, according to the latest international student survey by the Canadian Bureau for International Education, or CBIE.
UK student accommodation provider London Nest has added three new residences to its portfolio.
And so finally, what were you doing 20 years ago this week, Hans?
I was just about to start at the University of Plymouth.
Blimey. Well, many people in the industry were attending the first ever Alpha UK conference in London. On the eve of this year's event, delegates from 1998 shared their memories and perspectives on the impact of the conference in a special news story on our website.
Great stuff. And we've even dusted off a few photos from the event. Great fashion. And you'll find them in our Grapevine Gallery this week, along with Brown's English Language School celebrating its 15th anniversary.
Thank you for watching, and hopefully we'll see you at Alpha UK and the Study Travel Star Awards this weekend. Goodbye.
Goodbye.